Howdy folks, fixing to do a hopefully short video on a salvage procedure for a compressor like this. This is a 1/3 horsepower Tecumseh fridge compressor for a commercial fridge. And it came from a system that had a broken line on it. And it sat for no telling how long with a broken line. So we know that the oil in here is taking on moisture, and it's a R134A system, so we know that the oil in there is probably chemically sensitive to moisture, and once it gets contaminated, it's done. You know, the oil is degraded. So I'm going to change this oil and flush it out and replace the oil with new oil to be able to put this back in service and expect that it will have a reasonable life to it. And I know there's going to be haters and negative comments on this video. I just know it because I know how people are. First thing that's going to be said is that's a throwaway compressor, you're wasting your time. And that is in a way true. Most of these are throwaway. But the time will come that you can't just order another one and get it shipped over here and put it in use. You may not be able to get it. And we've recently had such supply chain issues here in the States and abroad as well. For general items, lumber, you know, any a lot of different things, we have supply chain issues. Well, the day's going to come where these are not available anymore cheaply from overseas. Might be within my lifetime, maybe not, but the day's going to come. And when that day comes, what used to be disposable is now precious. And you guys that are saying, throw this away, get another one today, you're right. In 10 years, you're probably not going to be right. And I want to get this procedure out there and show what's possible while we have spares. If I screw this up and ruin it, I'll just have to pay for another compressor. But if I don't, then I've taken this, which was headed to the scrapyard, and put it back in service where it's going to serve for years to come. The next hater thing that's going to be said is you don't know what kind of oil and you don't know how much oil to put in it. Well, that's bullshit because you can research and find out what kind of oil to put in here. And I'm not going to go into that, but the manufacturer has documents to tell you what it came from with the factory. And, you know, different refrigerants are going to be used in these systems, and what you're going to use in it determines what kind of oil it's going to take. So, yes, you can determine what kind of oil goes in it, and probably the quantity. But for the quantity, I'm going to take out the oil and measure it, so there's not going to be any question about the quantity. I've got a Pyrex measuring cup right here I'm going to use to measure it. So we're going to measure the volume, and we know what refrigerant's going back in this, so we know what kind of oil to use. And that's all those questions are pretty well answered. Manufacturer tells you the viscosity. So on with the show. These tubes that come into the compressor housing on the return side, suction line, and the service process stem line do go into the housing, and you can turn the compressor over and pour out the oil. However, the way this is manufactured, the casting or the casing is stamped inward to create a point for this tube stem to braze into, and it's probably a quarter of an inch or more on the inside. And if you try to pour it out here, you got a quarter of an inch pool of oil throughout the side. You're not getting a lot of it out. There's a huge amount of residual in there. And then the return line on different compressor models, that may go way into the compressor and have an end on it that's supposed to direct any accidental liquid return away from the mechanical parts. That might have a 2-inch piece inside there. We don't know. Nobody really knows what's inside every different model of compressor. And I don't know what's inside this one. I've never cut this model open, so I can't just say for sure this is a good point to pour the oil out, because I don't think it is. So to ensure that all the oil comes out, I'm going to actually drill a drain port in the bottom. So you can see I've already started cleaning it, but I want to start by having a nice clean surface. So, you know, just wire brush it till you have a good steel clean surface. And the reason for that is because the screw that I'm going to put in there, I'm going to actually solder that in with Stay-Brite 8 solder. Once this process is done, it's not going to be something you take out again and use for maintenance. It's going to be a one-time thing to do an oil flush on the compressor and put fresh oil in it and solder that screw in there, and then it's going to be just like it was before. It's considered a sealed unit. So that area is going to be easy to solder. Cleaning job's done beforehand, so I don't get any cleaning debris inside it. I've capped off the discharge and return or suction lines, and we have a service port. So I'm going to take the service port. I'm going to hook up nitrogen. I'm going to put just a little pressure. You notice these are just taped on rubber caps, so they're not going to take a big load of pressure. So turn on the nitrogen here if I can. I just want to get an idea. See, I can stop it by hand. Put it on there and let this housing build up a little bit of pressure. And that is so that when the drill bit breaks through, the chips and swarf are going to blow out. I don't want anything to go inside, but chips are going to come outward. And it's real important because it's a mechanical device. You don't want chips and metal in the oil, but knowing what happens when this type of oil is contaminated, is left in the system, that is certain death for the compressor. Certain death. It will fail. One or two metal chips in there, it might not be good for it, but chances are that's just going to stay in the bottom and not ever go anywhere. So we're going to exchange certain death with a slight risk. And, you know, life's all about decisions and risks and what's justified, what's worthwhile. And in this case, to save this, put it back in service and make sure it has a long life, I'm willing to take the risk that a little bit of a couple metal chips might fall inside versus leaving this contaminated oil in there. So I'm going to go with the number 8 by 32 thread screw for a plug. So I've got a brand new number 8 32 thread tap in the correct drill size for it. Again, I don't want to take any chance with a half-assed drill bit that's not going to make a clean hole or it's going to break. So I keep this set of tools in like-new condition just for these kind of jobs. And then in order to be sure that I don't drill into the compressor and hit mechanical parts, I'm going to put the drill bit into the drill and use this socket for a spacer. And I want to have just enough of the drill bit exposed to get through the compressor shell without, you know, losing control and going in all the way and, you know, damaging the compressor or breaking the drill bit off inside there. That would just, you know, be terrible. So that's as far as it can go in, and that's going to be enough to drill a clean hole. Put a little bit of whatever random oil I have handy on there. Now, if there is, you know, pressure inside the compressor with the nitrogen, low pressure, I'm drilling into a pressurized system, so needless to say, definitely have some safety glasses on, and you probably want to use a face shield because the chips are going to come out based on or come out by air pressure and or nitrogen pressure, but same difference. From it hits you in the face, you're not going to tell whether it's air or nitrogen. Starting to go in. There you go. Got a breath of fresh air or fresh nitrogen. But thankfully, my safety glasses kept the chips at bay. So now we've got a nice clean hole to thread out. Start in there, got a brand new tap. Go in there with. I'm gonna use the drill to do it. I know that's another thing that the haters are gonna hate on, but hey, it works. It doesn't have a flat side like some of them do. And the last thing I want to do is have it twist over to the side like that and break the tap. Okay, tap is all the way through. Turn off the nitrogen. In case anyone's worried about me standing here getting hit by nitrogen, as you probably know, air is like 70-something percent nitrogen anyway, so it's definitely not going to hurt me. So that screw will go in there like so to form an oil plug, and be soldered in place in the end so it's not going to seep. Now the only thing left to do is to drain it. So I'm going to reorganize the tabletop here and I'll come back and we'll pour out the oil. So I've got this old beat up ice tray that I can use to collect the oil in, and then I got this one that the ice tray fills up. I don't think this compressor will have all that much oil in it, but again, it's not something that I do every day, and I don't know how much oil's in it, so we'll see. You see how yellow that is? Let it have some air. Give it some nitrogen actually to help that come out. This is where I get sprayed with oil. Promise to laugh if that happens. That's most of it. Now, this system had leaks, so probably some oil was lost. And from what I've read, you know, the manufacturers don't tell you anything about it, but from what I've read, an extra, you know, 5 or 10% of oil isn't going to hurt anything. And so I'm probably going to go up a little bit on the oil charge when I go back together with it, just to be on the safe side, because I don't want to have it low, knowing that some leaked out. And this system is about 16 or 17 years old, so it could have leaked for a while and been cleaned up, and the leak evidence of the leak removed and cleaned up again, so there's really no telling how much it lost over time. And it had this service valve on it, so probably it's had its share of gas and go repairs over the years, so there's no telling really. And that oil looks kind of oxidized. So we're gonna nurse it back to health with a fresh charge of oil. So I'm gonna pour that out, measure it, and put the plug in, and then put some fresh oil in there. I don't think that's UV dye. I'm pretty sure that's yellowed oil. I don't have a black light with me to check and see. It could be UV dye. But based on what it smells like, I think it's just oxidized oil. So that is 1 cup of oil, or about a little less than 200 mils. Put the plug in. Got a fresh cup of oil over there. Going to hook up the vacuum pump to the discharge port on the compressor. Obviously, it has to be drawn out of the discharge and allowed to flow in through the suction, just because the compressor, you know, it's a reciprocating compressor with reed valves, and that's the only way gas flow can go through it. It's not going to let you suck oil back in through the discharge port with a vacuum pump. Take this cap off. This is my oil charging hose that I've used on many videos. I should just be able to put it down in the cup of oil, open the vacuum. And it'll go in there. We got some weather coming up out there. If the rain starts, I won't be able to narrate the video. Now I'm going to take this yellow hose and I'm going to loop it back onto the discharge fitting. In this configuration, this compressor can run and just circulate in a loop, and that will allow me to warm it up and make sure that any of the old oil that's just in the system is blended in with the new. And then we're going to change it one last time and then solder the plug. So I've got a RO41 temporary start relay device hooked up here. And I've undone the hose loop. I'm going to put nitrogen into the compressor first. Helps when you open the valve. I don't want oxygen and moisture in there when it's running, or at least to minimize it. I'm going to take this off and we'll go back with a loop. So that should, for the most part, help that be a nitrogen environment inside there while it's running. Because again, the goal is just to run it and heat it up and help to mix together any old oil with the new to get it off the interior surfaces of the compressor. So we're going to measure amps of current and go for a start. The compressor sounds wonderful. I mean, it sounds perfectly healthy. So hopefully that's the case. Hopefully that's true in that it's going to prove that it is still a good compressor. Generally, being a mechanical device, it's either good or bad. It's either functional or broken. And it doesn't seem to be broken yet, but a mechanical device is only as good as the lubrication it receives. So by getting rid of that degraded oil, I'm very hopeful and optimistic that the compressor itself is going to continue working. Whereas if the degraded oil was left in there, it would for sure have a really shortened life. So it's been running for about half an hour, maybe 45 minutes, and it's too hot for me to keep my hand on it for a long time. That's good enough. You know, it circulated, the oil in there, everything's mixed together, so I'm going to shut it down and repeat the process. I'm going to set it back up on those boards and drain the oil. It's a hot potato now, I'll tell you that. Got to have a little air for that oil to flow out. I'm going to let this one drip dry a little bit longer, since this is going to be the real deal. When it goes back in this time, it's going to be the system oil charge. It's going to stay in there and run with it. So I want to make sure all this temporary oil comes out. So I'm going to give it about 15 minutes to drip dry. So put it upside down on a cardboard tape roll so it'll sit like that. And gonna flow a little nitrogen. Just to make sure that, since I'm gonna be heating this up, I don't want any chance of any kind of a vapor in there that might flash. So I'm gonna give that a couple minutes of purge time with the nitrogen. While that's going on, I'm gonna take some brake parts cleaner on a rag. Wipe that down. And then I've done the same thing for this little plug, the little oil plug. So this is dry of all oil residue and clean. And I'll start it in there like so. Now to solder this steel, you need this acid type flux to stay clean, liquid acid flux. Just put it on a little flux brush and kind of daub it around on there like so. Move that rag away that had brake cleaner on it. And come in here with the propylene torch. come in here with a rag that has some water to get that flux residue off, since that would create a rusty spot. Like it never even happened. Got the next cup of fresh, clean oil. Everything's hooked up here with the vacuum pump ready to go. Here goes nothing. Well, going in there slowly but surely, that's fine. I see I'm mostly on camera. Now, in theory, this compressor should be ready to be put back in its system. Now, of course, it goes without saying that the rest of the system has got to be clean before this goes back, or else it's just a waste of time. So that obviously should go without saying, but I know I got to say it or people are going to come up with a bunch of comments. So the sanity check. I've got the low side gauge hooked up to the compressor suction in the service port, which goes into the housing. The suction has a rubber cap on it. So let me hook up the electrical connection again, and we're going to start it up. We're going to see how much vacuum it'll pull. Make sure that we're not beating a dead horse here. So if it's good, it should pull this down to on this gauge set, an indicated full vacuum. Which that looks to me like what a good compressor should look like. It's right there down to the minimum on the vacuum scale. If it's faulty, usually it might make 20, 25, but when they pull all the way down like that, I have good confidence that there's nothing wrong with the valves or the mechanism. Then it's going to hold for a while like that. Going to use nitrogen to fill it back up until I hear it coming out the discharge. Well, I hope y'all have enjoyed seeing this compressor get serviced here and put in a condition where it could be taken out of salvage and put back in use. This type of process I've myself and others have been using on antique and vintage compressors for forever, you know, those compressors that aren't in production, haven't been in production in 40, 50 years. A lot of people value the originality of their equipment and they want to have the original compressor or one like it put in there. No new ones have been made in decades, so if you find one that functions, you got to take every precaution to give it the best chance at life. But in spite of normally doing this on older compressors, I had this opportunity with this one to go through and video the actual process. So that's why this one got done on video. Hope y'all have enjoyed it. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to type them below. I do appreciate constructive and worthwhile comments. Thanks for watching.